I need a remote control version.
Well, I can tell you this. Every week it's been obvious you've been practicing something. Because I can feel that you make a conscious decision to not move your feet, where it used to be something I had to kind of chase you around about. So it's nice to see the improvements that you're making on your own. Now, that, even though I looked away at the end of it, that looked like he made the decision. Okay. The more you roll with that, though, okay. That's kind of like, I know if I feed my dog from the kitchen table, my dog's going to want to beg for food off the kitchen table. But I don't like when he does it. It's gonna end up being something like that if you spend too much time just being like, yeah, I know I did that, instead of trying to make it. He is a little off on the front, actually. He seemed off on the front. Like, watch his head bob a little. Like, ask for that shot again. If his head bobs, it's usually a front leg. Oh, but it was the hind left. Never mind. He made it very clear just now it was hind left. He's not resting as much as he used to, you know, which could be good or bad. You know, him getting some stall rest could be good for him. And now that he's having kind of the end low man, so having to be kind of on his feet all the time, maybe a little bit hard on him. But if it's arthritic, to eat. Okay. Well, I would ask if, you know, if you're finding that he's laying down.
Yes.
Okay.
You know,
Outside? Yeah. I don't think he's going to be able to comfortably lay down outside. He may get some downtime, but he's going to be, you know, because if I know how my boss horse is, if somebody's laying down, it's like, oh, yeah? Hi. How are you? Good. Well, let's see if he can work out of it. Because if it's, it may just end up being something that you're going to have to consider injections in his hock. I mean, they can do them in a stifle too, but just today it seemed a little bit worse than it's ever seemed. Like, if he had just gone to try him out, I would have been like, wait, you know, have a vet decide if that's chronic or if it's something injured. So he wasn't even that bad when we tried him out. But let's see if moving around helps him at all. I don't, if he doesn't seem to loosen up out of it, I won't suggest we try the cantering. Okay. Have you spun him out of a higher gait? Meaning, have you asked him to stop from a speedy trot or anything? Yeah, so like if he's on a circle, have you asked him to come to a stop from a circle? Have you asked him to at a trot? Okay. In fact, that's kind of what just happened. But is, and kind of a jog, I'm not that worried about it, but I would really reduce how often from a faster trot, because it's going to twist whatever's going on there. Yeah. And, you know, then just kind of be careful with his joints right now and see if we can't. It could be, like I said, arthritis flaring up because we had a lot of rain. It is worse than I've ever seen it, but see if he'll work himself out of it now. Let's go the other direction though, and let that have kind of the less weight bearing part of it, and then let's just see if he can loosen up a little bit going the other way, and then we'll try this way again. If it is stifle specific, but like I said, the vet did think it was hawk. If it is stifle, doing a lot of backing up, if you can find even a slight incline to play on, like out on the trail or out in the hunt field or something, having him back up hills would be helpful. Even backing down hills, but up hills would be better because it causes him to have to dig in and then get up over himself. Downhill would be more of a balancing issue, so I don't know if I would do it downhill, but I would definitely find little inclines, back him up some hills. Does he get breakfast and dinner? It might be an option to throw, you know, a gram of meat in his dinner. Or even if he just got breakfast before you put him back out, just give him a little handful of something with something in it. So that way, maybe if there is an inflammation, we can kind of get ahead of it. There's nothing, you know, obviously inflamed. Like, there's nothing, he's not injured. His feet are clean?
Yeah.
Okay. Not like potential for a rock in there that we didn't know about.
Maybe there.
stone dust, and sometimes they have some sharp little pieces to them. Could just be, you know, like a little tiny noxious rock in his shoe. There you go. You, my friend, need to take that face away. Yeah, such a ugly face. Yes, such a ugly face. Don't make ugly faces. Make pretty faces. My last one is at 2, and I'm hoping we're going to hook the trailer up, because we got to get Rio trailer loading. Not today, but yeah. Yes. Yeah, I can't do, my trying to start horses at their other prospective farms doesn't work. Yeah, and sometimes even multiple times in a day, you know, if I'm working on something and they're not, like Charlie I did that with, where, you know, if they're not really into it, but I've already spent 15 minutes, I found a good place to end, I might come back, you know, an hour later and see if we got a better mood. Or even they just needed that hour to soak on something they were struggling with. And Rio, he's really, really, really come around to, he was a horse that didn't even recognize humans existed. He would look right through you. So he's come around a lot to where he actually saw me coming to go get him, and he came to the fence. He didn't have a halter on, and normally he's wearing a halter because I can't catch him. When I left, he recognized my truck. He came from the middle of the field, put his head through the fence, and just stared at me. So I was like, okay, you know, I'm getting somewhere with him to where I know that he's recognizing there's something in it for him. So I think having him by my barn will help us kind of solidify that trust that we've developed. He's a neat little guy. I like him. Some kind of Spanish breed. I don't know, never heard of it before. Don't know that it's one that anybody would have ever heard of. Like, it's not supposed to be this hot at 4 o'clock in the morning. Oh, it's horrible. Yeah, I'm like obsessed with, ever since the first time I took a picture of what it looks like from the barn out, I'm like, now I'm obsessed with that view. I've always liked it, but I didn't know anybody else would like it. So we'll go this way. No, it's the way he's more comfortable. Because the left is the outside, so he'll be less uncomfortable. Yeah, he'll have more weight on his right on the inside of his hope. Gives him a chance to hit bottom, and he can kind of swing it out, you know, around the inside. He can't do that. And I didn't notice a big lameness in this direction. It's not a big lameness, it's a notable lameness. Right. Yeah, and I wouldn't spin him out of trot in this direction either. Because then it becomes weight bearing in that moment. So he's got a slight favoritism of it, but by no means would I say, oh my God, this horse is lame in this direction. Go ahead and ask him to pick up the trot a little bit faster. Let's see how that bothers him. Put your hand forward and just push him. There you go. Yep. Put your hand forward, push him a little bit more. Good. Okay. Now ask him to jog. Slight wiggle. If he asks, just reassure him that it's not going to stop. Yep. Now we got a little bit of a bob going on. Okay, go ahead and ask him to walk. Now ask him to yield. Let's see what he does going the other way. Yep, and he's swinging. Did you see him swing that hind leg? Which is why I wanted him to have that on the outside. I was just saying before you got started, bothering him, he's going to swing it. Because when they're on the outside, they have the ability to do that. When they're on the inside, they're going to wait there. Okay. So when you just hind yielded him, that leg literally swung out. No, instead of just staying under himself. Instead of, he should have crossed like this. But instead, he went, ooh. Okay. So let's see what he does going the other way. This will definitely only do it at the jog. So the one thing I would work on, which you could work on today, is asking him to go out on the circle without bringing his hind legs off the circle. So that way he doesn't do that drive-by that he just did.
Okay.
Because we don't want him to get in the habit of doing that.
Okay.
Let's just say someday you get a bigger horse. You'd want to be pretty practiced at not letting a bigger horse come in on a circle like that. Not that he can't hurt you. As little as he is, he can still knock you over, I'm sure. Okay, go ahead and ask for that jog. He's got a little bit of, he's actually acting like it's the right hind. He's got a little bit of a hippie hop going on there. No, he's hopping. So, I'll send him out. You stand up there and I'm going to look for it. So, when he puts this leg under himself, he hops off of it. Okay? So watch for that. He's actually showing it in the right. I know he had both hawks tested. So it got worse as he went around more. They're kind of hopping off of it. Right there. Nordstrom. Go that way. Thank you. Nordstrom. He's the most lame he's ever been. Possible he got kicked? Or is that kind of part of it? Very rare do you find a horse in community. Well, it's figured out.
I wouldn't have gotten off the hook for me.
You wouldn't have noticed?
I wouldn't have seen it, you know. He always seems a little off.
Right. Well, there's, you can feel like apprehension in his body. Like that kid that, you know, stands staring at the door and bumping into mom.
You done talking?
Yeah.
This is earwax, right?
Yeah. It's sweat. Yeah. You can cut both if there's one on each ear. And just cut them off. I don't think you're putting anything in his ears for bugs, right? Yeah, so it's just from sweat.
Yeah.
Do you think it might be better for him to have more smaller? The only reason I'm going to say yes is because it came from my. my barn with substantial downtime. I mean, I've never seen him this late. So the routine is different, you know, there's different tendencies that he's getting more time wandering. Arthritis, you think, the more they're out, the better it is for them, so they get taken in. You know, he has no inflammation, so, you know, it leads to believe it probably is more arthritic than something happened.
Why do you think he has no inflammation?
There's no inflammation, there's no obvious, like, he didn't get kicked in his leg, blown up.
Yeah, right.
Yeah, there's probably definitely inflammation in the joint. Well, at least it's nice that she, you know, it's nice that she's not like, oh, yeah, you need to see me 3 times a week, you know. I'm sure some, especially in the economy, you need to, but now some people would do that. It seems unusually tight for what that's not. You know what I'm saying?
Uh-huh.
Yeah. It just seems very tight for being not fit. Like, I would say he's a racehorse, and that was tight for showing it. Fitness, you know, because of fitness. But
have you ever used Dr.
I've never used Rhinebeck, they won't go as far as me. But they might come here. Yeah, do you have Tim's number? Ask Tim, because I think the chiropractor he uses is from Rhinebeck, and he swears by her.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I did not swear her. It was like
2 months ago. Oh, okay. Yeah, that's one hell of a farm call. That's one hell of a farm call. Yeah, I never used Dinah that way, so I can't speak either way. Yeah. And it might be something where you can get them on a monthly, you know, I think so. Adequan, for joints, like the monthly joint thing.
Uh-huh.
Injection, and that might be something to consider before you do injections, like injections. Because I mean, I don't know that if they would say he's a good candidate for that yet, but it may be where you can at least get him in some kind of like the senior mare I had, she was on Adaclon. It was a once a month injection, and she had a really bad hip, and that's all we ever had to do for her. She lived out for the rest of her life without ever needing any kind of other intervention. It was a lot. It's an intramuscle, it's not venous. Yeah, I mean, who knows? He could have run around like an idiot last night. It could be he's sore from the 4th of July. Maybe the fireworks freaked him out. You know, we don't know what could have overstressed him, but this is, I've never seen him this lame. That's new, but that looks more like a scratch. Like he rubbed up against something. Or it could be a hip, but that looks more like he rubbed up against something. That's fresh skin in there. Either overuse of joints that already hurt him, or, you know, he's, because of the weather, he just had, you know, the humidity and everything, could just be more aggravating to him. He wasn't by me in the summer, so we don't know what happens to him in the summer. Yeah, you know, because I know I get, my joints get more inflamed in the humidity, so... You know, it's hard to say what we have to have him for a year to know what his deal is, and then if it reoccurs the following summer, then you know definitely. But yeah, that's just to me, this is the most lame I've seen him. But I can't, you know, to say yes, he should rest more. I don't know. To say he should have more time outside, I don't know. It's the only thing that's new. I mean, his feet is the same. Cosequin's the same. The only thing that's new is his amount of time standing. Yeah, I wouldn't. I wouldn't think a supplement would be it. No, I would think it'd be overuse or lack of rest on that would be might be causing discomfort. And again, could be just a weather related thing. Like tomorrow, he'll be fine. It could be 4th of July, freaked out running around from the fireworks or something.
We'll see how he is.
Yeah, sure. And even best for me would be you stand in the center of the round pen and have him go out on the round, on the circle, and just videotape him moving on his own. Because chances are, if he moves more freely too, we'll see it either more obviously or less obviously. You know, because maybe he's being controlled in the. This type of circle, so to speak. Yeah, and you know, it could be just stomping flies, you know, just stomping down. It could be a combination of all kinds of things. Just, I've never seen him this lame. He's not ridiculously lame, but yes. I've never seen him. And I would definitely reduce how often you spin him out at a faster speed. Because he's more likely to clip his sweat box and stuff in doing it at the fast. I mean, they're capable of it, they're trying to do it, but I would say with potential joint issues, yeah, there's something to do that. I also like that Zero Bite, the one that I use, because I used to use Repellex, and then Shayna and I would go out for a ride, and she'd have the Zero Bite, and those bugs just loved Ritz, and didn't want anything to, So one time I asked her if I could borrow a spritz of hers, and she's like, and I said, no, I'll repay you, you know, I'll spray him down with my sugar. I don't want to just spray him with that crap.
Zero Bite,
yeah. Yeah, that's the one I use, and it's not too brutal on me is because Lapella exfoliates. That gives me a migraine instantly. This gives me one after about 5 horses are sprayed.
Seeing, I mean, I don't want to be like,
no, I could once I watched from out, you know, I'm like kind of.